we measure use of the nation's highway system in excruciating detail, but we know much less about how the system is performing. And so this project was an effort to develop a comprehensive measure of how well the U.S. highway system is performing. Travel speed and travel time are both important measures of how the system is performing, and so we focus on those two measures. Another reason we think this is an important issue is that travel time is by far the largest component of the overall economic cost of moving both people and goods throughout the U.S., and we want to know how large that cost is and how it's changing over time. And on a related note, we're interested in the burden that travel imposes on the what you might call the time budgets of households and businesses. Since time is, I think if you think carefully about it, it's the only truly non-renewable resource. The bad news is that the data demands are extensive, primarily because we need measures of vehicle miles of travel and speed for the same times and places. And those data turn out to be extremely scarce and the major challenge, technical challenge that this project faced. The state data provide nearly universal coverage of major highways and roads, but progressively less coverage for smaller roads. The speed data come from a separate data set that has only recently is recent in its origin by comparison to the highway performance monitoring system, which has been around for decades. Our speed data come from the Federal Highway Administration's National Performance Management Research data set, which reports average speeds for 5-minute periods on a limited network of roadway links that are called traffic messaging channels. The big problem is that the two networks don't coincide, and they describe the same road and highway system, but the division of that system into links is completely different in these two data sources. So the big challenge is in matching the two. We use GIS methods to match each traffic messaging channel to one or more sections on the National Highway Performance Monitoring System, that turns out to be quite a time-consuming and detailed process, but we've ultimately succeeded at matching a high proportion of the two networks together. Because we're reporting this measure at such a high level of aggregation, there's lots of stability in it. It doesn't vary a lot from year to year. This graph, which also compares our estimates for 2014 and 2015, focuses in on a subset of the previous one, which is travel by automobiles only. This normalizes it per licensed driver to make it less abstract and hopefully give it some familiarity. Interestingly, this resorts the ranking of the states in a way that tends to place rural states where trips tend to span very long distances, but speeds can be quite high. These data average just under an hour a day, that compares to 0.96 hours per day reported on an average travel in household vehicles of 0.96 hours a day. Reported in the 2009 Nationwide Household Travel Survey, and the American Time Use Survey for 2015 reports about 1.1 hours per day. So we think we're in the right ballpark, but those are both relatively small samples, and so whereas this is a comprehensive nationwide estimate. There are many potential applications of this. One is to develop reliable estimates of delay for both metropolitan areas and the nation as a whole. Undoubtedly, you've all seen and heard the Texas Transportation Institute's estimates of travel delay, and we're interested in how our estimates will compare to those. Because of the spatial resolution in our with which we construct the estimates, it's also possible to distinguish between normal rush hour, what's sometimes referred to as recurring delay, and that caused by incidents or road construction projects and special events and abnormal weather. Of course, maybe the most obvious application is to monitor long-term trends in travel speed and time, since, as I indicated previously, these are important measures of the way in which the highway system is performing.